clergy to the foundation. We would like to welcome you to our annual half-calf ceremony. So I know some of you guys have never heard of a half-calf. Like I shared with the students downstairs, this is something to honor them, to encourage them, and to let them know we appreciate them for staying on track to graduate. A lot of times freshmen are always given all the love, and then sophomores are overlooked, then you start junior year, you start like, okay, then senior year, all this hoopla. So we want our sophomores to know that we appreciate them, we value them, and we want to encourage them for being on track to graduate. And as I shared with some of the students, well, I shared with the students, there are some students that are not here. We have a lot more sophomores in our program than what you see today. That means they did not maintain at least a 2.5 GPA, or they have an F in one or more classes. So these students are to be honored and to be appreciated for what they're doing, their hard work and the efforts during this trying time. You know, it's very difficult during our COVID, in COVID coming out. This is probably many of them first time really in high school full time. And for them to maintain their grades and to do what they need to do, they are to be saluted. So let's give them a hand. About what the parent group is doing, what you guys have planned. For those who are not in the parent group, you guys can reach out to us. So Ms. Dana Burns.
Good morning. I see a lot of familiar faces, but the parent group is basically just us getting together, camaraderie. You know, we always doing for our kids. In school, out of school, activity here, activity there. And 2022 is all about self-care. I know some of us, especially moms, not to leave out the dads, but we don't take care of us. And this is a way to take care of us, but also support Dr. Dixon. If you have a business, she is definitely needing the information for that because she does want to, you know, celebrate her parents in that way of, you know, using them for the business. We do have a Parent Taco Tuesday coming up, April 19th, so save the date. Information is coming, we need to solidify the event, but that's about it. If I don't have your number, see me after this so we can get you in the group meet, and we meet every first and third Tuesday on Zoom.
Now, their parent meeting is different than what I have with the parents as well. So we normally meet the third Tuesday of every month, but because this Tuesday, well, that this third Tuesday will be on a college tour, so we'll meet the fourth. So the parents have got together and they decided to come together to be that outlet. They had an awesome party here, kickback. We normally have a kickback for the kids, it was a kickback for the adults. They had a good old time eating chicken wings and dancing and playing games. So parents need that outlet. You need to release sometimes. So it's okay. So this is the space for you guys to do that. Okay? I'm going to bring up one of our scholars now to bless us with a song, and that would be none other than Miss Kayla Barnes. Give her a hand. She's a little nervous.
Somewhere.
White is a 24-year-old dynamic and ambitious young woman hailing from Harvey, Illinois. In November 2021, she graduated from Northwestern University Full Stack Developer Bootcamp and recently accepted a position as a Salesforce Technical Apprentice at Discover Financial Services. At Thorne Township High School, Ms. White was active in numerous activities such as the Student Board of Education, Students Against Violence Everywhere, and National Honor Society, just to name a few. She continued her education at Illinois State University, where she received a bachelor's degree in politics and government. Ms. White has received several accolades and awards throughout her high school and college career and beyond. Two of her fondest memories was when she studied abroad in China at the age of 14 and in Peru at the age of 18. Jessica's also a future Young Leader honoree awarded by the Gloria J. Taylor Foundation. Jessica envisions herself utilizing her imagination, innovation, and influence to help create opportunities and allocate resources for melanated people. Ms. White is a multifaceted and is passionate about sharing her life experiences and wisdom with the hopes that it would inspire others to live boldly and authentically. I present to you Ms. Jessica White.
Better than that. Give it up for yourselves. So as Dr. Dixon stated, my name is Jessica White. I am from Harvey, Illinois, which is right up the street from y'all. So we are neighbors. So treat me as such. We are family. Are you guys ready to have some fun? Woo! Awesome, awesome. Okay, well, first I would like to congratulate all of you beautiful sophomores for making it thus far. This is amazing. Half-cap ceremony is awesome, and I am so proud of each of you guys for all of your accomplishments, so keep it up, okay? And shout out to the parents, right? We couldn't do it without the support system, so shout out to everybody. Awesome. So I wanna play a game with you guys, or an icebreaker. It's called This or That. And so it's gonna be a little bit of a rapid fire. I'm gonna shout some things out. I need you guys to shout back if you know what I'm talking about, okay? Awesome. TikTok or Instagram?
TikTok.
Sleeping in or stand up late?
Sleeping in.
Summer or winter?
Summer.
Apple or Android?
Apple.
From the sophomore class to come up and tell me who is your favorite superhero and why. Come on. I need one more. Awesome. Give it up for them as they come up. Hi.
What's your name?
Dominique.
Nice to meet you, Dominique. How are you?
You too. I'm good.
What high school do you go to?
Rich South.
Awesome. Who's your favorite superhero and why?
Black Widow, because even though she doesn't have power, she's strong and an independent woman.
Okay. I like that. Hi, what's your name?
Justin Questa.
Nice to meet you. How are you?
I'm good today.
Awesome. What high school do you go to?
I go to Rich Township.
Awesome. Who is your favorite superhero and why?
I'm going to have to say Batman, because even with that power, he's still like, he still manages to keep up with like all the other superheroes that Justice League and Superman.
Awesome. So I'm gonna tell you who my favorite superhero is. Outside of myself, I would have to say it's Zuri from Black Panther. She used her intellect, her imagination, and her innovation to help the people of the nation of Wakanda. She used technology and different items just to keep everyone moving and pushing forward. So awesome. So, high school is a pivotal moment in time. I remember remember sitting in that exact same seat as each of you guys are sitting in right now. I remember feeling happy to almost be done with school. You could get out of the house, right? I remember feeling anxious about my future and whether my plans would pan out for myself, as well as excited, right? Like, this is a new terrain that you guys are going through and dealing with. And with that being said, here are four super facts that I wish I knew in high school. It spells out the word hero. H is for help. E is for explore. R is for resilience. O is for opportunity. Now, has anybody in the room seen Infinity Wars? Any hands, any takers? Okay, okay. If you haven't seen it, please go rent it. It is an amazing movie. So in the movie, do you guys remember the Avengers who were trying to defeat Thanos and his family from taking over the universe, right? And so they were like, okay, we don't have enough people on our team. We have to call some help. And so what I want you guys to know is that in high school, there will be peer pressure. There will be distractions. There will be things that try to knock you off of your square. But you have help. Not only do you have, like, family, you have your teachers, you have mentors and people here at Gloria J. Taylor Foundation who are here and want you to succeed. And so I want you guys to stand in you and call for help. Ask for help. They will come and they will run and help you. Also, as you're going through life, I want you to assess who you're surrounded by. Does the people that you connect to, do they match your vision of yourself? Whether that's friends, whether that's mentors, whether that's just anything or anybody, like, where are you going and where are they going and does that align? The way that I stayed focused and stayed out of trouble in school is I found a mentor. I surrounded myself with the right people who wanted to see me win, who celebrated me, who uplifted me, and who saw me for me. And I want the same for you guys as you're going through your high school career. Okay, so what does H stand for?
Help.
Ooh, good job, good job. So please do not be afraid to ask for help. We are here to help you. So E is for explore. In the same movie, do you guys remember when Dr. Strange was meditating and he was doing like this, like going through all of the possible outcomes of what could happen? He went through 14,605,000 outcomes of what could happen between that war between them and Thanos and his children. And only one did they win. Now, I'm bringing this up because it's super important. I want you guys to be able to explore the different possibilities, explore the different sides of yourself, get into different activities, learn new things, enjoy the season that you're in as well, because time is truly flying. And you guys are really young, and this is like the stage right before like adulthood, so I really want you guys to take risks, do new things. If you guys have activities or programs at your school, join them. If you see that there's a need for something else, make it, create it. Don't wait for someone else to do it, okay? As well as travel, go on field trips. I remember I took Chinese my freshman year of high school, and I went to Thornton, right? So y'all know what Thornton is, right? So I didn't think that I could, but they had an opportunity for students to go to China. And I went to China at 14, legit graduated, like finished my freshman year and went on to China. So take advantage of what they have. Don't be afraid to step out and take a leap. So what does E stand for?
Explore.
Good job, we're halfway through. So R stands for resilience. Do you guys, has anybody in the room watched Black Panther when they go like this? Yes? Can I see a show of hands? Yes. Yes. Okay, awesome. How did you guys like the movie?
Love it.
Awesome. Me too. That was my favorite movie, honestly. So T'Challa and Zuri lost their father unexpectedly. However, they were still expected to run the kingdom. And they were super young, and they're like, okay, I have to become the king. And she took over with the technology and things like that. And so I want to let you guys know that life is filled with many lessons, and there will be disappointing situations that you may feel like you can't triumph over, but you must dig deep within yourself and keep going. In high school, I lost a friend to gun violence. He was a part of the Students Against Violence Everywhere club that I was in. He was on the speech team, as well as, you know, he was just a bright light, and I had to still forge ahead. And so what I did was took his light with me and kept going. So I want you guys to dig deep. I'm not saying that life is easy. It does take determination, but if you persevere, you will make it. So what does R stand for?
Okay.
O is for opportunity. Does anybody know who Iron Man is? He has that circle in his chest. He'd be like, awesome. So originally, he was called Tony Stark, and he worked for the U.S. military, and he recognized the opportunity to work for himself and create his own suits of armor out of machines. And so there's a quote that says, life's greatest adventure starts with a single leap. And so for you guys, there are so many opportunities and miracles happening all around you. And I want you guys to be able to see it. I want you guys to seize those opportunities and take advantage of it, okay? Awesome. And do what feels aligned for you, even if it scares you. I'll be honest, when I got a message this week like, hey, can you come and speak? I was like, oh. Like, oh my goodness, I'm so nervous. I don't know like what to say or what to impart, but I still did it. I said yes, and I kept going. And so me standing in my truth and my power, it got me here. So what does O stand for?
Opportunity.
Now if we put it all together, H-E-R-O spells what?
Hero.
What does it spell?
Hero.
What does it spell?
Hero.
Awesome. Now what if I were to tell each and every one of you in this room that you have come here to leave your mark on the world. That the same qualities and traits that those superheroes possess, you do as well. So if a self-limited thought came in like, why me? I wanna push back and say, why not you? Your potential has no boundaries. And when you follow what lights you up, develop a strong sense of self, and recognize that your power comes from within, you become unstoppable. As the hero, you all get to define what success looks like for you. And I just want to note that simply being is enough. We are grateful for each and every one of you being here and showing up as yourself. You are magic personified. Everyone doesn't need to become a celebrity, but we do need people to do our nails, right, ladies?
Yes.
People to do our hair, right? People to cut your hair, people to cut the grass, people to grow your food. And so what we truly need is for people to show up as themselves and share your light with us. That's what you all came here to do. And so I just want to leave you with this. Just imagine what life would look like if you shine your infinite, unlimited light, knowing that there is no one on this planet or the next that can do it like you. Your superpower is showing up as yourself. So I just want to say congratulations again. Make sure you guys keep your capes on and go out there and keep smashing your goals. Congratulations, and I look forward to hearing about the great things you all accomplish. Thank you.
She brought back to my memories a young man that passed away when we was working with SAVE, was an advocate against gun violence and ended up losing his life to gun violence. So I admire you for continuing to let his light shine. So his living was not in vain, and what he was trying to do and to help the community was not in vain. So let's give Jessica another hand. So now we're going to have a poem by one of our counselors, Ms. Tierra Taylor.
Never stop believing in yourself. When others doubt you, don't you. Do what you love to do. No one knows better than you. Life is too short to live other people's dreams. Follow your own dream. Push yourself to reach your goals and live the life you once dreamed. Trust your instincts. Be true to yourself. You know what is right for you. Never give up or give in. Forget the words, I don't know how. You can learn, you can research, you can do. Your mind is powerful. When you believe you can, you will find a way. You won't waste a day. Persist and persevere. Do not fear, because if you believe in you, you will find dreams can come true. May all your dreams turn into goals. Believe in yourself. And remember, all of life is a choice. The decision is up to you. Believe in yourself. Dare to be whatever you want to be.
Thank you, Ms. Taylor. And now the time that we have been waiting for. Our presentation of our sophomores. I'm going to ask Board Member Angela Pope, Board Member Taylor, and CFO Taylor to come stand. As the students come, you can shake their hands. Your kid wants to know that they love you.
Opportunity to celebrate you and get used to being celebrated, doing positive things. That's what Half Cap is to me. Thank you, thank the parents, thank our staff for the hard work that they put in with all the students, and just I wish you continued success.
I want to thank my staff so much for their efforts. With me, it's like you never know what you're going to get, who's going to show up. Dr. Dick, you know, T from Harvey, just never know who's going to pop up any day today. But they are awesome. They're learning to adapt and to just, and they understand our passion and commitments to help our students. So I want to acknowledge our counselors and our staff. We got Mr. Singleton that works out at School District 215. Mr. Boyd is running around somewhere, but Mr. Boyd is Rich 227 counselor. We got Mr. Taylor that works out at Crete and Rich 227 as well. Tiara Taylor, who is our middle school counselor for Colin Powell. We have Ms. Sullivan, who is our ETS counselor for Michelle Obama. And in the front office holding everything down is Ms. Cynthia Taylor. So we have some seniors here that actually had an opportunity to go to Los Angeles with us. Every year we take our seniors to LA for their senior trip. This year we were not fortunate enough to attend the NAACP Image Awards, but we went anyway.
It is, while we're renting an office, not renting from someone else, don't look like us, we might well come down the street and pay some money to somebody that look like us. Yeah. If we're gonna pay, we might well pay someone that we love. And we knew their mom, we love Teresa, we love Cliff, and we're always looking to enhance Gloria J. Taylor Foundation. And I just made some connection today, we'll talk about it, that can help us and help the youth, help you guys. And that's so important. And we are entrepreneurs by spirit, and we just in honor of Teresa and Cliff and what the board is doing, what the family's doing. And you guys are in the right place at the right time with this organization, because it can take you to a whole nother level. And you have anything? Well, you know, that's what I'm saying.
older I get. Oh, good. But I am just, I'm just floored. And I know Teresa probably just get tired of me saying how amazed I am at everything in the journey. And this is just simply beautiful because she's honoring her mom. You know, and what she does with the children, you know, a lot of events that Teresa, it's like, God, are you the Energizer Bunny? You know, and she doesn't mind one of those trips, and it's just a beautiful thing. When you have a love for children in you, and when you see it in someone else, you know, that is really, really special. So it's just been an honor to be on this board, and I am looking forward to when we could really, they don't need any help, but it's always good because they're doing amazing. But that's my personal commitment, is to continue to see everything that they want to do, you know, and I just, the opportunity, and I just thank you from the bottom of my heart for the opportunity to be on the board. To me, it's a privilege. So I'm happy to be here.
Mm-hmm. So thank you, already blessed. The babies can eat first, so you guys can line up. Dixon, you can play some brunch music.